Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today we have a question sent in by Canvas. Actually, tomorrow we're going to get to his question. Today I just want to do some preliminary work on this. One of my favorite statements, and this came to me from a fellow named Eric that I used to work with. Eric had a real wry sense of humor, and he would talk about impossible requests the managers would give, something like, "Hey, can you take all those worksheets and total them diagonally for me?" Well, you know, that, you have to laugh at that because that's something that's really hard to do if you needed to go through and total a data set diagonally. But it turns out that there is a formula that will total diagonally. I got this from Chip Pearson. If you don't know Chip, Chip is another MVP, a longtime MVP. He has a great website at cpearson.com. Chip wrote to me one day. He said, "Hey, you know, I saw that on your website, and it turns out there is a formula that will do that." But let's take a quick look at this formula. So it's an array formula. We had to use Control Shift Enter. Basically, it says we're going to take the row of this entire range and see if it's equal to the column of the entire range, and then multiply that by the range. Now, let me show you exactly how this works. I'm going to go to another worksheet where I set up each bit of that. In the first part, what is the row of the range? So that just gives us the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's the column of the range? Well, that gives us basically the numbers 1 through 5, but going the other way. So everything in column A is 1. Everything in column C is 3, everything in column E is 5, and then the formula says, see if those two numbers are equal. So here's an if statement. It says, if the row number equals the column number, then basically give us a 1, otherwise give us a 0. And you'll see what that does is it gives us 1s just along the diagonal of the matrix. And then here, finally, I've put our original numbers, and the final result says, take that array of zeros and ones and multiply it by the original number. So what we get then is just the numbers along the diagonal, the 30, the 50, the 29, the 40, and the 46. Finally, because we have a sum around the whole formula, it sums it up, we get 195. We'll go back to the original formula here, 195. You'll see that it works if I would change one of these numbers, 44. It does accurately work. Now, Canvas sent in a question, and I'll talk about that tomorrow because it's much more difficult, but it uses this exact same trick. So thanks for stopping by. I will see you tomorrow to figure out how we can create a more robust diagonal formula to solve Canvas's problem.